an accident today. It was the last surviving drive-in around Rochester. And as News Source 13's Bill Murray reports, when it comes to drive-ins, it may indeed be the last picture show.
Man, don't take long to burn, does it?
Ironically, the fire that destroyed the Lakeshore Drive-in was captured on the very thing that helped to kill the drive-in concept to begin with, a video camera and VCR. Modern technology, convenience, and life in the fast lane all have turned many drive-ins into ghost towns. People just don't go anymore.
Must be about 10 years now. I really don't remember.
30 years ago? 20 years ago? I don't know.
I don't quite remember the movie. I don't think I was watching the movie at the time, but it's been since 14 or 15 years old.
Butch McDermott works across the street from the Grease landmark. His memories are distant but sweet. The drive-in recalling youth, innocence, and summer love.
Taking my favorite girlfriend, actually. Yep, we used to have a lot of fun. Try to sneak a couple of people in if we could in the trunk. Other than that, it was a good time.
But the drive-in died a slow death. It closed last year for good. Today, one spark finished in an afternoon what an entire demolition crew had been working to do all week. Now, members of the Lakeshore Fire Department say the fire started shortly before 11 o'clock and took about 3 hours to put out. At this point in the investigation, it is being labeled an accident, a salvager's blowtorch igniting a pile of wood behind the big screen. For some firefighters, it's part of their childhood going up in smoke.
Been down here on the lakeshore for as long as I can remember, and it's just another thing that we lose along the lakefront. I think it's the last one in the community, matter of fact.
And by early afternoon, with one big push, the show was over. Bill Murray, News Source 13.
And I suspect that one gentleman was not alone. Many of us snuck people in the trunk on the way of the drive-in. For trivia buffs, the last movie that played at the drive-in was Buffy the Vampire Slayer. That theater opened back in 1954. The owners, National Amusement in Massachusetts, have no plans for the property at this time.